One of my favorite things to do on this channel, I often say, is to show complicated apps and show how they can be easy to use, but I also love showing new and interesting apps from smaller developers. And today I'm gonna show you one of those in the second category. So if you ever need to create subtitles for videos or audio files on your computer, this is gonna be an awesome app for you. So I'm uploading a video to YouTube right now, and traditionally I've used the automatic subtitles that YouTube does, and they're fine, but they're not perfect. And I actually have a tool now that is completely free. There is a pro version, but I'm showing you the free version today, so you can do this completely for free. Just use the link in the description, get the app, and you can do all this yourself. Basically, here's the video that I'm uploading to YouTube right now. And if I want to create subtitles for it, I just drag it into MacWhisper. It's going to transcribe for me. It's using OpenAI's Whisper API or something. I'm not totally sure exactly what it's called. I'll try to put it on screen here to make sure I get it right. But you can see it's transcribing this 10-minute video. I'm on an M1 Pro device right now, and it's basically transcribing the whole thing. It is doing this offline. I am online right now because I'm uploading the video, so I can't prove that it works when I'm offline. But I've done it completely offline. No Wi-Fi, no Ethernet. It still transcribes wonderfully. So if you have privacy concerns, you could just disconnect from the internet, do your transcription, and then reconnect once you're done. But it's, as far as I can tell, it's not using the internet at all, but it's doing its thing. We kind of scroll through and see everything that's going on. And you can check it, you can edit little bits here, but in general, I find it incredibly reliable. So now I can do a couple different things, but ultimately what I want to do is just export. And an SRT file is kind of the standard subtitle file that includes timestamps. Everything. There's some other ones if you want to export it as HTML, PDF, or a .e file. I don't know what those are. You have to pay, but let's just export. We'll save it to my, yeah, or we'll save it to the desktop. How about desktop? There we go. So now it's up there. And if I bring back this, I can just add subtitles. I can upload a file with timing because it does have the times there. And let's go ahead and, there we go, Mona final, so that's this file. Open, there we go, and it has the timestamps, it has all the words here. And I can double check it, but it's pretty darn accurate, so I'm just going to say done. There we go, next, and then we just kind of go through the rest of the upload process, but that's it. There's no limits, as far as I can tell, on how many files you can do. You can see I've done a couple of my most recent videos using this. It's really, really great. Like, you can upgrade to Pro, and you can get higher, let's see, you can use larger language models to get more accurate transcriptions. Like I said, it's pretty darn good for me. You can paste in a YouTube video URL to transcribe it. I guess you can batch. Anyway, you can pay for a couple of these additional features, but I'm using the completely free one, link in the description. Check it out. Awesome, awesome app.